The director of the Caribbean Drug and Alcohol Research Institute says current restrictions are not enough to influence young people against smoking, as they are constantly being targeted through the internet, magazines, films, concerts, and sporting events. Alarmed by the rising numbers of juvenile and female smokers, the director called for tougher anti-tobacco regulations, including a total ban on advertising.
Cigarette advertising should be banned. I don't agree with necessarily banning cigarettes because people are going to smoke whether you want to or not, but I think that promoting cigarette smoke, which has proven to be very harmful, is a detriment to the community. I mean, if people are going to take up smoking, that's one thing, but encouraging people to smoke is unethical.
Dr. Day says he is deeply concerned about the escalation in smoking and other forms of tobacco consumption by children and adolescents, particularly young girls as well as women. He says that Saint Lucia, for its part, should follow the European model.
I think that we should definitely monitor who we sell cigarettes to. They should not be sold to minors. They should not be easily accessible. I love the European model where they have tobacco stores and you have to go to a special store to buy your tobacco. You can't buy it in the grocery store. You can't buy it in a corner store. And so therefore they make it a little more difficult to get and a little more difficult and a little better to control. And I think that that's a good model that we should follow.
The director of the Caribbean Drug and Alcohol Institute believes one way to control the spread of smoking is to work towards a total ban on all direct and indirect advertising of tobacco products. Reporting for the DBS News World, I am Cecil Actill.